Hello everyone, my name is Karolina Jurkiewicz. I'm from the University of Silesia in Poland, and it is a great pleasure to give this short presentation on this conference. Today I'm going to talk about developing of the structure of non-graphitizing carbons as alternative materials for anodes in lithium-ion batteries. So nowadays, the state-of-the-art materials for anodes in lithium-ion technology is natural and synthetic graphite due to its low working potential, quite high reversible capacity, and cycling stability. The artificial graphites are usually produced by graphitization of cokes, which are called soft carbons. In contrast to soft carbons, non-graphitizing hard carbons exhibit wide plateau on the cycling profile, providing much higher capacity related generally with the micro and mesoporous structure. So the porosity and the small size of the graphite-like domains provide fast lithium transport channels and reduce the solid electrolyte diffusion length for lithium, and thus render the cycling rate. So the microstructure of hard carbons can also buffer well against the local volume change during lithium insertion and thus enhance the stability of the structure. However, simultaneously, the nanoporous structure and high fraction of edge sites cause the solid electrolyte interface formation, reducing the initial Coulombic efficiency and capacity with cycling. Moreover, it results at lower energy density than graphite. So the aim of my studies is to develop low-cost and easy-in-production materials based on hard carbons with improved capacity compared to graphite and better cycling performance compared to standard hard carbons. I focus on the synthesis of graphite materials capable of providing a compromise between high reversible capacity and low irreversible capacity loss. As you can see, these both properties are directly correlated with the specific surface area of graphite. So the idea is to produce materials based on hard carbon with reduced surface area and enhanced degree of graphitization. For this, I employed the process of catalytic graphitization in the assistance of the silicon-based catalyst. So this process can be carried out in two ways. First, the way is the addition of the silicon-based dopants to carbon precursor and heat treatment at standard graphitization furnace at 3000 Celsius degrees. The second way is that the pure hard carbon is heat treated in the standard graphitization furnace, but in the presence of the silicon vapor. And the resulting materials have slightly different properties, but they both resemble the atomic scale structure of graphite produced from soft carbons. So let's verify it. So here you can see the differences in the morphology of soft and hard carbons graphitized in the presence of the silicon vapor. So you can see that cokes form irregular lamellar-like particles, while non-graphitizing carbons from sucrose and furfuryl alcohol polymer, they form wires and various polyhedral crystals. So now let's have a look on the atomic scale structure of these materials. Here you can see the comparison of diffraction patterns of pure soft and hard carbons graphitized at 3000 Celsius degrees with their counterparts graphitized with the addition of silicon. In case of coke, you can see that there are almost no difference between both materials, catalytically graphitized or normally graphitized. They result in almost the same structural parameters. While in case of hard carbons, the presence of silicon dopant induces spectacular transformation of their atomic scale structure. That is manifested as the appearance of graphitic diffraction peaks, and also the drop of interlayer distance and increase of the size of the crystallites. You can see that they are comparable to the values obtained for graphite from coke. So globally, the graphite-like structure of catalytically graphitized high carbons is revealed. Also, Raman spectroscopy as a complementary global structural probe demonstrates the transformation of the structure of hard carbon when they are catalytically graphitized. So you can see that the size of the crystallites in plane direction calculated based on the intensity ratio of the D to G peak is comparable for cokes and even slightly greater than for graphite from graphitizing coke. So this is because the measured intensity of the D peak is comparable for both soft and hard carbons catalytically graphitized. So in turn, the high resolution transmission electron microscopy showed that locally the structure of catalytically graphitized hard carbons differs from the structure of these carbons graphitized in the pure form at the same conditions, as well from the structure of soft carbons. So you can see fragments with great graphitized domains. However, you can also see that the nanoporosity is partially preserved in the catalytically graphitized hard carbons. So this results in higher specific surface area of those material comparing to the artificial graphite from coke. However, the surface area can be tuned by selecting the proper catalytic graphitization method and concentration of the catalyst. So here, for comparison, you can see the carbon from sucrose, but graphitized in the presence of the silicon vapor. In this case, the BET area is significantly reduced than in case of sucrose sample graphitized, but in the presence of the silicon dopant. So the reduction of the porosity and the surface area is also confirmed by high skeletal helium density of this material that is close to the theoretical density of the graphite crystal. In summary, the hard carbons derived from sucrose and polyfurfuryl alcohol polymer graphitized at 3000 Celsius degree in the presence of some specifically selected silicon-based dopants or silicon vapor, in contrast to pure precursors which do not graphitize at these conditions. And the obtained nanographites from hard carbons do not contain catalytic impurities. They are pure carbon materials, and they have global structure resembling the structure of artificial graphite synthesized from soft cokes. However, the porous structure of hard carbons may be partially preserved and is tuned by the catalytic graphitization method. So the developed materials combine the structural advantages of hard carbons with the benefits of graphites, and the next step is their electrochemical testing in lithium-ion batteries. Thank you for your attention, and I am waiting for your questions. Have a nice conference.